paragraphs into the Rolling Stone article is when I started crying. And it wasn't because I started reliving what happened to me, but because that article was so calm and complacent and politically correct that I was heartbroken. When I was a student at UVA, I had an elective art class in the building across from Bank of America on the corner. I was working on a project kind of late into the evening, and I left around 10:30, 11. I don't know how, but I didn't hear the person coming up behind me, and I felt a hard blow. I think he had used a rock or a brick. When I came to, it was when he was finishing off and hit me again and climbed off, and by the time I turned around, it's just a shadow. After that, I was so depressed that I stopped going to class, and I didn't seek help with my friends. I cut them off too. I had to go to student health because I was on my period at the time of my rape, and I had to go to get them to remove a tampon. I thought I could just delete it from my mind and get over it because, you know, it happened and there is nothing you can do to change that. But I crashed that semester. I failed every single class. By the time that I really started to get back to myself, you know, start to fix myself, I was taking summer classes and getting A's and B's, but the dean at the time, this was her last year, the dean called me in for a meeting, and we talked about how my classes had been that previous semester, and how they were kicking me out because of my grades. And so I told her what happened, and she just said, well, you should have taken a medical leave. There's nothing you can do now. You've already failed out. So, you know, I wrote letters, and it was, you know, the same thing, just, you're done. I mean, you know, there's nothing you can do. And it's so heartbreaking that so many girls go through this. And why aren't people getting so angry? The only reason that it took me this long is because only now, you know, when this story is trending, you know, the flavor of the week, people are gonna listen. You just get so angry. This shouldn't just be one of the discussion topics at your board meeting. This needs to stop. And it's not if you keep one student from being raped, then you win. It's that if you have one student that's raped, then you fail. I don't care what you have to do. I don't care if you have to hook every single student up to a lie detector to find out. You need to find the rapists, and you need to charge them as adults. And this has to stop. So get angry, be proactive, and tell the alumni this could have been your child too, so you need to fix it.